beaten into second place in the Grand Prix finals by Megan and Eric, but they are super consistent. This is, of course, Xenia Stolbova and Fedor Klimov from Russia. Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon, the music. And the last piece, House of Flying Daggers. Fabulous flow. Just incredibly confident on the twist. And if you watch, her arms never stop moving throughout the program. Foot perfect on the toe loops. And there's the triple flip. She does it with a delay. Amazing. A little mistake there. My word. Super consistent, these two. How do you split those two teams up? Technically, I'd probably have these two ahead because they did the flip as opposed to the loop on the throw, and the synchronization of the side-by spins was better. But
then there was a little bit of the glitch on the step.
A little stutter on the step.
Because when they'd done the side-by-side spins, I thought, well, okay. So there is a differential there. And then there was just that tiny, tiny little thing. But overall, probably, this is a beautiful routine. The music, fabulous choice. The costuming is great. The aura they create within it, in particular, she is pulls focus.
Yeah.
It's fabulous.
There's not going to be much in it going into the free, and it's all going to be down to the free. Look at that technical score getting closer and closer all the time. It's going to be nip and tuck at the end of this one.
Because of the quality and the surety of those elements.
They are so well trained, these two.
Both those Russian couples, just
incredible.
It's so tight, isn't it?
Can you imagine the atmosphere and the tension for the free? It's going to be sensational. 69.87 would do it for them. Look at it. Technically, they've just got their nose ahead at the moment. What will the judges do with that second score? Look at some of the highlights of the program again.
Her expression in the midst of that really matches the music, the mood. Didn't spend a lot of time on the running edge on the back of the toe loops.
Yeah, actually, she put her foot down pretty early, didn't she?
Toe caught on the end of that. So as we see it in super slow-mo, there are elements there. Just little questions.
Yeah, I think that's why that technical score came down, just losing it a little bit on the GOE. Probably the base value of the program was higher.
And maybe some of the judges haven't taken the super slow-mo on certain of those elements. That's maybe, and maybe that's why it's taken a bit of time. The character, the choice of this music, and then the character that they've portrayed within it, just fabulous. And the second mark, the artistic section, always favoring if you can create something that's an overall concept.
I love that exit out of the spin.
There's the one stutter, and she did just fight a little bit on the second bit as well. And a gap.
Yeah, they may lose a level on that, you know, because she missed the loop, and that would have been one of the turns that they'd need for a feature.
Okay, here we go. 69.87, they've done it. 71.38, that second score, 34.62, as opposed to 33.44.